Good day, my dear friends. Welcome back to Easy and Different Radiology. I am Dr. Osama Ibrahim. Today, our appointment number 7 in the FRCR anatomy. So let's get started. Today, I will talk about the muscles of the chest and abdomen. As you see in this diagram, this is a diagram showing the abdominal muscle. The anterior, most anterior and the middle part is the rectus abdominis muscle in both sides, right and left, separated by linea alba. And in the anterolateral aspect and anteroposterior posterolateral aspect, there are three muscles in both sides. The outer one is the external oblique muscle. Next one is the internal oblique muscle. And the most internal one is the transverse abdominis muscle. So this is the anterior muscle of the abdomen, or the anterior abdominal wall muscle. Let us see it in the CT examination. This is CT exam in axial image, and showing this muscle. This muscle is the rectus abdominis muscle in the left side, and this one, which is labeled by the blue color, is the rectus abdominis muscle in the right side. So this is the right rectus abdominis muscle, and this is left rectus abdominis muscle. In between of them, there are linea alba. Laterally, there are three muscles. The most lateral one is the external oblique, and next one is the internal oblique, and the most internal one is the transversus abdominis muscle, as shown here in color. Between the rectus abdominis muscle and these three muscles, there are another linea here. This is which is called the linea semilunaris. However, posteriorly, there are erectorospinae muscle just paralateral to the spinous process, as we'll see it in details in next slides or in the end slides in that presentation. Just follow me. And the other muscle between the psoas and the erectorospinous muscle is the quadratus lumborum muscle, which is seen here also. This is the quadratus lumborum muscle, psoas muscle, and this muscle is the erectorospinous muscle, which have a group of muscles. I will talk on it in the separate slide in details. So this arrow referring to the linea alba between two rectus abdominis muscle. As we know, this is the rectus abdominis muscle, which shows the rectus cheese hematoma or rectus abdominis strain as the most common pathology in that region. And this another arrow, which referring to the linea semilunaris. And this linea semilunaris, this region is the site of the potential site for the Spigelian hernia. This image is the coronal image, CT examination, and this arrow referring to the internal abdominal structure in the left spleen, and in right is the liver. Because that presentation is talking mainly in the muscle of the chest and abdomen, so I will mention these abdominal organs first. This arrow referring to the uterus, and that arrow referring to this muscle in the pelvic regions posteriorly, referring to the left gluteus medius muscle. I have one presentation talking about the pelvic muscles in details also. I will leave the link in the descriptions also here. And these are referring to the spinous process of the lumbar vertebral bodies. This is a spinous process posteriorly. And these muscles, also group of muscles, I will talk about them in details at the end of the presentations. This referring to the erectorospinae muscle. And these are referring to the last rib in the left side, left 12th rib. And here, these are referring to the scapula. And there are some muscles surrounding the scapula, like this arrow, which referring to the left supraspinatus muscle. And the outer muscle on the scapular surface is the left infraspinatus muscle. The most internal one, just adjacent to the scapular surface, is the subscapularis muscle in the left side also. However, the muscle in between the ribs is called the intercostal muscle, which are three groups of muscle. The arrow here referring to the right intercostal muscle. And this arrow referring to the CSF within the spinal canal and the spinal cord. This diagram showing one muscle here or group of muscles which appearing anteriorly locations at the that ribs, and this muscle is called serratus anterior muscles. Serratus anterior muscle originates the surface on the surface of the first 2/8 ribs at the side of the chest and inserts along the entire anterior length of the medial border of the scapula. So it arising from here 1/8 and going to the scapula to inserting in the medial surface of it. Let us see it in the diagram or in the CT, real CT examination, axial image. This is CT axial image post-contrast study as the contrast showing in the aorta and also in the hepatic veins here, portovenous face. This arrow referring to the previous slide which I talked about this muscle which is called serratus anterior muscle in the left side. So this is left serratus anterior muscle, just deep to this muscle which appearing here at the posterolateral surface of the lower chest and the abdomen and upper abdomen, which is called latissimus dorsalis muscle. So this is the serratus anterior and this is the latissimus dorsalis muscle. However, this arrow referring to this muscle which located paraspinal or paraspinous process, which is called the erector spinae muscle on the right side. What about this muscle, which arising from the here in these locations and extending to the arm? This muscle is called latissimus dorsalis muscle. And latissimus dorsalis muscle originates from the spinous process of T7 till to T12 vertebrae posterior, arising also from the posterior third of the iliac crest, 9th to 12th ribs also, and the inferior angle of the scapula. All these site is the origin of that muscle, latissimus dorsalis muscle. And going by a thin tendon, this tendon inserts into the floor of the bicipital groove of the humerus. Let us see this latissimus dorsalis muscle in the CT or MRI images. We saw it already in the previous slides. However, this slide showing another muscle here in the anterior aspect of the chest. This is the chest and this is the branches of the aorta, subclavian, carotid, and innominate vessels. So this is the upper chest level and this is the sternum. And there are two muscles here. This muscle, which is big one, and there's another smaller one in the anterior chest wall muscle. This muscle, smaller one, is called the pectoralis minor muscle, right pectoralis minor muscle, which appeared here by dark brown, and also in this magnified image appearing here as that yellow label. However, the other arrow referring to the largest muscle here, the largest muscle in the anterior chest wall, is called pectoralis major muscle here in the left side. So this is the left pectoralis major muscle, which appearing here also in the magnified image by red color, bounded by red color. Let us talk about the posterior muscles in the paraspinous region. First of all, this arrow referring to the thecal sac, this one, and thecal sac containing multiple nerve roots, these dark dots, which is called cauda equina nerve roots. However, this arrow referring to this ligament, which is appearing here in posterior aspect of the lamina, which is called ligamenta flava. And this arrow referring to this whiteness in this axial T2 weighted image, lumbosacral spine, white posterior to the thecal sac, referring to epidural fat. And this one is the lamina, right lamina and left lamina. However, this one is the spinous process posteriorly, posterior spinous process. However, this is two rounded structures anterior to the vertebra, is the inferior vena cava and the aorta. This muscle, which appearing in the paraspinal region anteriorly, is the psoas muscle. However, the muscle between the psoas muscle and the erector spinae muscle is the called quadratus lumborum muscle, this one. And this one is the erector spinae muscle, as I mentioned. And this one is the multifidus muscle. Erector spinae muscle have another details. I will talk about it in the next slide. Another level at the level of the disc. This is two images of the same level. This is the level. Is one is the sagittal T2 weighted image as the CSF and the nucleus bulbosus fluids appearing bright. And this one is axial T2 also as the CSF appeared bright within the thecal sac. What about this green one? Green one referring to the paraspinous muscle anteriorly, it referring to the psoas muscle. However, the paraspinous muscle posterior referring by these two muscles, erector spinae muscle laterally, and the multifidus muscle most medially in the adjacent, just adjacent to the spinous process in both sides. If we wanted to talk in details about these regions also, the next slides will show that. Here, this is T1 weighted image as the CSF appearing dark signal, and also this is a coronal image which is showing these paraspinal muscles in the coronal view. First of all, this one is the psoas muscle, which appearing anteriorly. However, these red margins referring to this muscle, which is called the erector spinae muscle. The erector spinae muscles consists from two muscles, this one lateral and this part medial. The one lateral is called the iliocostal muscle because it connecting between the ilium inferiorly and the costal margin superiorly. So this is the iliocostal margins in the coronal view, which appearing longitudinal view like this. However, the L referring to the longissimus muscle, and the longissimus muscle also in the coronal view appearing here in these locations, and both of them is called the erector spinae muscle. However, the most medial one, or the most medial adjacent one to the spinous process, is the multifidus muscle, which also appearing here in the coronal view MRI T1 weighted image for the lumbosacral spine. I hope I provide you with a clear knowledge about the muscles of the chest and the abdomen. You can follow my Facebook group also by the same name, Isn't Different Radiology, or you can watch more than 100 presentations in my YouTube channels with me every Wednesday and Sunday for a new lessons about the case review and FRSR part 1. Thank you very much for watching and have a nice time.